Welcome back to the channel, where today in Power BI, we are going to work on a little bit of formatting, creating a Dax measure so that we can create a dynamic card title and use the conditional formatting function with that measure to show the last date. So we're currently analyzing some data and we're halfway through the year and we want to quickly be able to see when we're looking at the revenue for that what is the last date of data that has been added to the report. And whether you're doing a manual refresh or getting in static data and importing that on a monthly or quarterly basis, this dynamic card will update and it shows you how to use the conditional formatting to use a measure to bring that into the card. So it's a dynamic card with conditional formatting. Let's go to Power BI. Back in Power BI, and today we're going to create a dynamic card title with conditional formatting. And what we can do here, you know, we're in the middle of 2023. We have data that goes through May 2023, and we can visually see that in a card. So this is our finished product. We are going to create a measure with DAX that calculates the last date of revenue in the calendar table. And then we're going to use what's called dynamic conditional formatting. And where it is in the formatting options, you can hit the FX button, which is the conditional formatting. And we're going to use that measure last period to calculate this out so that we get this card to dynamically update depending on the year. So for 2022, it shows the last date, December. For 2021, it shows December. For 2023, we currently only have data through May. So let's make the measure and then we'll put it into a card so we can see a dynamic update. Power BI, let's make a dynamic card title with conditional formatting. So we have a card and currently it has the DAX measure total revenue. And when you look for 2020 on the slicer, $1,310, 2022, $5,350. So we're in 2023 and we don't know the last date of data. If somebody was looking at this report, they would start to wonder when the last date of data was. So with DAX, we can actually create a measure that calculates the last period. So you start off by your syntax of naming the measure. We're going to call it last period. And then we're going to create a join with text and with the measure. So we're going to go total revenue. We're going to add a space and then close out the text brackets. And then we're going to add the format because we want to format this out. And we're going to now actually find the maximum date in the table that we currently are using. YouTube is the fact table. So we're going to format that and we're going to use the max. The max again returns a value. And what we want is the table column name or scalar value. So we want the column name, which is in YouTube, and it's the YouTube date. And this is the correct one. And that'll bring up that. Then we're going to format it to close out the max statement. And then we're going to bring down the conditional formatting to join total revenue and the format. And the format we want to be parentheses. MMM will get you small month. And then YYYY will get you a 4-year return. And then what we're going to do is join that with year to date. And then we're going to close out the text. And this will get us the last period for the DAX statement. So you're combining a max of the date in the YouTube fact table, and we're formatting it to month and year, and then joining that with total revenue. So once you have the measure, you can start to work on seeing how the conditional formatting works. We've created the measure last period, which is the DAX measure that calculates the last date of the YouTube fact table that we are using in this data model. So now all we need to do is, first off, we're going to check to make sure that it's working correctly. So we're going to create a new card, and we're going to populate into this visual. We're going to bring in the last period, and the last period is May of 2023. So we know that the Dax measure is working. And now we go to the card, and the first thing we want to do is format this card. We are going to turn off the category label. So the current category label is the name of the measure, which is total revenue. We are going to turn that off. And now we are going to add a title by turning that on. And then rather than typing in the name of the title, we want this to be dynamic. We are going to hit the conditional formatting button. And what this does is brings up, we're going to format this field value based on a measure, and we can bring in the measure last period, and that'll be the conditional formatting. And as that measure changes, it'll automatically get dynamically formatted into this table. So we're going to bring in the last period, and now we will accept that. And now this comes up at the top. So we are going to then format the title. We'll use heading 3. We'll make this a little bit bigger. And we'll make this wider. We will center it. And we will choose a different font. We'll use Arial. And now, when we click on the different years in the slicer, 2020, the last reporting period was in December because that was the last month of the period. We're formatting this to the month and the year. Remember, in the last period DAX function, we went MMM, which is a 3-digit code for month, and then the year is 4 digits with 2020. We click 2022, the last period is 2022, and then the last period in 2023. And we can format however we want. And remember, we're doing all of this with just one DAX measure, which is the last period, and it's calculating. We're using the format function, which is the month and year, and then we're combining that with some text, formatted text, total revenue, and then we're adding in and year to date at the end. And then inside that, we're using the max function of our fact table, which is YouTube, and we're using the last date. So really, it's just one DAX measure, and then we're using the formatting of the conditional formatting for this card, and all we're doing is bringing in the last period measures. So this is very powerful. You can make one DAX measure and have a dynamically formatted conditional formatting card. So make sure to use this when you're thinking and kind of preparing your dashboards. Again, you're always trying to make your reports more valuable to the user, easier for them to use. And as a Power BI developer, you want to think how the end user is going to use this report.